मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इन लास्ट पीरियड वी सी यूज ऑफ माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स. दैट मीन्स एट होम वी कैन यूज इट, इन एग्रीकल्चर वी कैन यूज इट, इन साइंस एंड इन मेंटेनेंस ऑफ एटमोस्फेरिक फिक्सेशन और बैलेंसिंग वी कैन यूज इट. सो टूडे वी कैन सी द माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स विच वी कैन यूज, नंबर ऑफ यूज विल बी देयर. दैट माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म और दैट माइक्रोब्स क्लासिफिकेशन वी कैन सी. How it will be classified? To five ways it will be classified. In your textbook on page number 18, they will be classified. First, bacteria will be there. Second, fungi, protozoa, virus, and algae will be there. So these five types or these five classifications of microbes we can see point wise. Okay, we start today first bacteria. Okay, we go with first part. Bacteria. Where we can see them? Okay, these basic concept we can see, and after that, some bacteria are useful and some are harmful. That also we can see. Like microorganism. When we start microorganism, we can see some microorganisms can be useful and some are harmful. Like that classification of microbes. In that also we see five types: bacteria, virus, algae. That also some are useful and some are harmful. So we can go with these points. First, bacteria. How they are? We can see point wise. First point, bacteria are simplest, most diverse, widespread organism on the earth. Very simple, and everywhere they can found on the earth. First point. Okay, bacteria everywhere we can found it, and that bacteria is very simple. So first point is very simple and found everywhere on the earth. Okay, second point, what consists of simple rod like or spherical shell, some spiral or corkscrew shaped. Means how they are, very simple I will write. But shapes are very important. Round shape, rod shape, okay. Number of shapes will be there. So they gave you in the picture also structure of bacteria. It will be rod shape, round shape, okay. So how the shape is? Rod shape, round shape, or spherical shape, okay. These shapes are very important. Then after shape, how is the size? Size is also important. Like a human being, weight, okay, height, color, okay, all these concepts we can consider. Like that bacteria when we see, or microorganisms when we see, we can consist, we can go with these basic concepts. Where they found, how the shape, how the size, etc., etc. So we see where they found, we see shape also. Now we can see size. How the size? Size is minimum 1 micron without nucleus. Okay, size is 1 micron without nucleus. It consists a single cell or in the form of chain or group of chain. Means it is not number of cell, group of cell. Unicellular and multicellular. Have you in your brain or not? I don't know. But single cell, unicellular, number of cell means multicellular. So this microbes means this bacteria having single cell only or with the form of chain or group of cell, means unicellular also and multicellular also. Size we see, shape we see. It is how big with the one cell or group of cell, means unicellular or multicellular. Then size varies from, we see basic, how the size with 1 micron without nucleus, but I will tell you now only next point, it will be unicellular or multicellular. Having one cell, then size is very small, but group of cell will be there, then size will be bigger as compared to single cell. So size varies from, I will write here, size varies from, because of uni and multicellular, it varies from 0.2 to 100 microns. Okay, 0.2 when it will be single cell or two cell, three cell, and up to 100 microns means group of cell will be there. So it will be depends on number of cell, the size varies, but basic it will be 1 micron without nucleus. Then average size of bacteria is 1.25 microns in diameter. This will be size overall, and in diameter overall it will be how many? 1.25, yes, microns in diameter. Okay, average size overall, round, rod shape, any shape, the diameter 1.25 microns in diameter, it is 5. I will write again. Some bacteria are harmful bacteria, up to 6 to 7 points. it will be finished. So these points are very important. When I will write these points, you can note down these points because it is very important. After that, in the textbook they gave you bacteria which is harmful and which is useful. So beneficial bacteria are given. They gave the use of that bacteria. That points we can see in next lecture. So what is your homework? You can read all these concepts and then come back to the lecture. Then you can understood 100% and point wise write down the answer. So thank you all of you and come back again.